Sunnyvale, and you're watching the 6 o'clock news on Channel 6. Now that the Great War is finally over, the effects are proving to be in literature, art, philosophy, music, and in the people. Literature is showing a sense of loss and a fear of the future. The authors, F. Scott Fitzgerald, Ernest Hemingway, and John Day Pascus are writing about the Lost Generation. The Lost Generation is a term popularized by Ernest Hemingway. It means that the men who came to age during the Great War are lost because they came back home either physically or mentally wounded or both. They have no chance of a normal life. They are aimlessly going through life. The new books out are The Second Coming, The Trial, and The Castle. The Second Coming by Butler Teeth conveys a sense of dark times. The Trial and The Castle by Franz Kafka are about people caught in terrifying situations who don't always get a happy ending. The new style of writing demonstrates a lack of hope and faith in the people. Art is now depicting a sense of emotion. Before the war, art was realism, and now it is surrealism. This is an example called The Garden of Earthly Lights. Many of the emotions depicted in art are dark. Artists George Proc and Pablo Picasso are painting a new style called Cubism. New philosophers John Paul Sartre and Friedrich Nietzsche have new ideas about life. John Paul Sartre believes there is no universal meaning of life, that each person creates their own meaning of life. Friedrich Nietzsche believes we should return to values of pride, assertiveness, and strength. A new type of music has started in the United States. It is called jazz. Here is an example. Type of music that's full of joyful melodies and a swinging beat that originated in New Orleans. The Great War is over, but the effects of the war are taking its toll on the people who survived the war. The Great War has forever changed the people who lived through it, for better or for worse. And now to Rebecca with an intriguing report on the flu.
Okay. Thanks, Beth. This just in, 1,000 more people die in America, adding to the 20 million people that have already died in the world. The cause of death was the rapidly spreading Spanish influenza pandemic. Now, the United States' average lifespan has decreased by 10 years. The people with the flu that are still alive are miserable. They are in the hospital just waiting to die. This has affected not only the people who are sick, but the whole population. Small children have created a rhyme about the flu. One fifth of the world is infected with this disease. There is no escaping it. Even U.S. President Woodrow Wilson suffered from the flu while also trying to make the treaty to end the war. In India, the mortality rate is 50 deaths from the Spanish influenza per 1,000 people. Some new health measures have been set up. Citizens, all funerals have been limited to 15 minutes, and stores may not hold sales, and gauze masks must be worn at all times in public. And new tax officers have been hired to collect a fine from those who do not wish to follow these rules. Shortages of coffins, morticians, and grave diggers have been reported. This means that the victims' bodies are piling up. Studies show that this influenza is verging on conditions similar to the Black Death of the Middle Ages. Even though the war has ended, soldiers coming home have to deal with the horrible conditions that have invaded their homes. Half of the U.S. soldiers who died in Europe were killed by the flu, not by the enemy. Nations are trying to deal with the cost of the war, but also have to deal with this flu. Fortunately, the people have accepted these new measures and put their country's needs above their own. Scientists are now working on new vaccines to save us all. And the Great War has ended, but we are battling an even more cruel one, the influenza.
Thanks, Rebecca. I'm here with Dr. Esperanza from Spain. Can you tell us more about the pandemic?
Well, it's a horrible sickness. I've seen many deaths now.
It starts out with people in their 20s, or those who live on the streets. That's terrible. How does it spread? The disease is spread by coughing, the normal ways. It is spread around the world from people on trade ships and the traveling soldiers.
Oh, of course. I've heard that some of the symptoms are painful. Can you tell us more about them?
Painful? That's an understatement. Victims cough a bloody froth from their nose and mouth.
Yuck. That's a little bit uncomfortable. So just for the viewer's knowledge, how would people know they have the influenza?
It has the symptoms of a normal cough or cold. Coughing, fatigue, runny nose, high fever. Then it progresses to the flu, with the victim's symptoms becoming worse and worse until they are bedridden.
So you wouldn't really know until it's too late. It allows a chance for the influenza to spread, huh? How exactly do they die?
This is the most horrible part. Once the blood-tinged froth comes into their throats, they are basically dead. They have a slow, painful death, suffocating until they can't breathe anymore.
That's unfortunate. It doesn't only affect the infected, it affects the people at home too?
Well, yes. During the Great War, most of the physicians were sent to help overseas. That left few people to help the sickly. So in place of doctors, medical students helped out. Sometimes hospitals even had to ask for volunteers.
Well, that must have been a burden for a lot of people. I can just imagine how hard it would be to experience that pain. Thanks for being with us today, Dr. Esperanza. Back to you, Rebecca.